I offer my humble pranam at the lotus feet of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Welcome to video lecture on microprocessor laboratory. In this lecture, I am going to explain how to compare two strings, STR1 and STR2. So, using string instruction, like compare string byte instruction. So, write an assembly language program to compare two strings using compare string byte instruction. Now, first we have to discuss how compare string works. Compare string. Here we have two compare string instruction: compare string byte, compare string word. Now here we can able to compare two string byte by byte, here word by word, 16 bit at a time. Now if you execute this instruction, it gets one character or 8 bit number from the memory location pointed by DS with SI, then it's going to get another character from the memory location pointed by ES with DI. Then it takes the difference. According to the difference, all flags are affected. But the content of this memory as well as this memory remains same. It won't change. Now, according to the difference, all flags are affected. After comparison, automatically the content of SI and DI is incremented or decremented by 1 depending upon the status of direction flag. That is, if both are incremented by 1 if direction flag is reset, or decremented by 1 if direction flag is set. In the same way, it is going to compare with word, that is 16 bit. It is going to get 16 bit number from string 1 or array 1, and another 16 bit number from another string, says str2. It takes the difference. According to the difference, all flags are affected, but the content of the memory location remains same, no change. Then after comparison, what happens? Automatically the content of SI and DI is incremented by 2 if direction flag is reset, or the content of SI and DI is decremented by 2 if direction flag is set. Therefore, if you want to compare two string, it's a more efficient instruction. Using this, we can able to compare two string. Now here I'm going to consider two string. STR1 contains Sairam and STR2 contains another string called Sriram. Here Sairam and here there'll be Sriram. The length of string 1 is 6 characters. The length of string 2 also 6 characters. And the star means segment address of string 1 must be in ES. The segment address of string 2 must be in ES if you want to use compare string byte. Then the offset or the base address of string 1 must be in SI, and the offset or base address of string 2 must be in DI. It is fixed. You are not supposed to use any other 16 bit register. Now here the dot model, so small dot stack dot data. Here we have to declare both the string str1 defined byte Sairam. Defined byte means it indicates the size of each character. Therefore, Sairam is stored starting from str1 Sairam. Then I want to find the length of string 1 in general. Therefore, L1 define word dollar minus str1. Dollar means it gives the ending address. str1 gives the starting address. Ending address means after M. Therefore, str1 gives the base address and dollar gives ending address. The difference gives the length. That length goes to L1. Now, according to this case, L1 contains 6. Then immediately afterwards, str2 define byte Sriram. Then I want to find the length of string 2. L2 define word dollar minus str2. Therefore, str2 gives the base address and dollar gives the ending address. Therefore, ending address my starting address, the difference gives the length of string 2. Then see, we have to display the appropriate message. If string 1 equal to string 2, display string equal. If string 1 is not equal to string 2, we can say string not equal. Say two messages. Then initialize data segment as well as extra segment. Therefore, if you want to use any string instruction, we have to initialize extra segment also. Now, if you want to use a compare string instruction, therefore, we know that the segment address of source first string 1 must be in ES. The segment address of string 2 must be in ES. The offset address of string 1 must be in SI. Then offset address of string 2 must be in DI. Therefore, I have to initialize all these things. Therefore, load effective address SI comma S. The get the, actually here I made a mistake. Here that is load effective address SI comma STR1. This must be STR1. Then load effective address DI comma D. D is nothing but here actually STR2. Here STR1 and here STR2. Then load effective address. So if you want, we can modify now itself. Okay, now I'm just going to modify this. That is load effective address SI comma str1. That is str1. Then load effective address DI comma str2. So I have to modify this. Okay, then save this. Okay, from current slide. Okay, now here what happened? That is initialize data segment as well as extra segment, load effective address SI comma str1. Therefore, the starting address of string 1 must be in SI, the starting address of string 2 must be in DI, the count must be in CX, that is here move CX comma 6. Next is here, actually in this case, what happened? Here move CX comma 6 is there, na? Actually this is not required. So what we'll do is, I'm going to remove this instruction. Now here, that is the last starting address of string 1 must be in SI, the starting address of string 2 must be in DI, then so move CX comma L1. What is the length of string 1? The length of string 1 is in L1, transfer the L1, content of L1 to CX. Now CX becomes 6. The length of string 1 is 6. The first thing is, before comparing actual elements, individual elements, first compare the length of string 1 with length of string 2. If length of string 1 equal to length of string 2, then only you can proceed. Suppose the length of string 1 itself is not equal to length of string 2, so no need to compare individual characters. We can declare string 1 is not equal to string 2. Therefore, first I am doing this job, move CX comma L1. Therefore, the length of string 1 comes to CX. Compare the content of CX, which contains length of string 1, with length of string 2. Length of string 2. Suppose if it is equal, we can conclude at least both length is equal, then we can proceed further. Therefore, compare CX comma L2. CX gives length of string 1, then L2 means L2 gives the length of string 2. Suppose afterwards we can make decision. Jump if not equal. The length of string 1 is not equal to length of string 2. We can conclude, we can display the message string 1 not equal to string 2. But in this case, Sairam is not equal to Sriram. But the length of Sairam is equal to length of Sriram. Therefore, this condition becomes false. It comes out. Now we can go for compare string byte. Now if you go for a compare string byte, it's going to get first character from here. Yes. And first character from here, yes minus yes, the difference is what equal. According to the difference, the zero flag will be affected, zero flag is set. Then after compare, automatically the content of SI and DS incremented by 1. Then after this, we have to go for next thing, loop equal. What is the meaning of loop equal? Then decrement the content of CX by 1. Then rest step number 1, then if the content of CX is not equal to 0 and 0 flag is set, means if both are equal, see here S minus S equal, therefore 0 flag is set, that condition also satisfied. That is loop if equal, therefore it is going to decrement CX by 1 and it will check both. If CX is not equal to 0 and 0 flag is set, if both conditions are true, then it goes to next, compare string byte. Now it gets A here. And here R, A minus R, the difference is not equal, therefore 0 flag is reset. Then automatically the content of S and S incremented by 1. Then it comes to this. Now loop equal CX equal to CX minus 1, decrement CX by 1. CX not equal to 0, okay fine, not equal to 0, but 0 flag is set, no, it is reset, this condition is false, it comes out. Now here once again we have to check the states of 0 flag. So 0 flag is what? Reset. Therefore not equal means if you execute this instruction immediately, it's going to check the status of zero flag. It's going to check the status of zero flag. So zero flag is reset because A minus R, the difference is not equal. Difference is not equal. Zero flag is reset. This condition is true. Then it takes you to this memory location. Here we are going to display string not equal. Therefore, here I am actually control won't come here as per this example. as per this example. Therefore, if this condition is true, in this case this condition is true, because A minus R is not equal, so it comes out of the loop. This condition is true, it takes you to string not equal, a string not equal, load effective address dx comma m2. Actually m2 is nothing but string not equal. So if you want to display any message, the base address of the message must be dx, the service number must be in AH, that is 9, then INT 20 minutes. Therefore, with the help of these three instructions, we can able to display any message on the monitor. That's where displaying the message using DOS interrupt INT 21H, before invoking this, the address of the message, base address of the message, the offset address of the message M2 must be DX and service number 9 must be in H, then INT 21H. Now it's going to display string 1 is not equal to string 2 or string not equal. String not equal. Then after displaying this message, therefore terminate. Say terminate. Suppose if you assume, so here Sairam and here also Sairam. By the time, just keep executing until CX equal to 0, CX equal to 0, and in all the iterations, the 0 flag is set, means loop equal, all the 6 characters, S, here S, A, let it be, here Sairam, here also Sairam, or here Sriram, here also Sriram. By the time what happened, so just keep executing all iteration, all the cases, in all the cases, what happened, 0 flag is set, therefore loop equal next. So finally what happened, CX becomes 0, it comes out. When CX becomes 0, it comes out, means it's going to compare each and every characters, all 6 characters, then finally CX becomes 0, it comes out. After coming out, I'm checking the states of 0 flag. I'm looking for not equal, but 0 flag says that, 0 flag says that equal, because the last character is what, M, and M, this also equal, 0 flag is set. If I'm looking for not equal, 0 flag says that equal, this condition is false, it comes here. Load effective address dx comma m1. M1 is nothing but string equal, then I'm displaying that message. The first we have to load the offset address of m1 to dx, then jump display, it comes here, it's going to display the message, then terminate. Then terminate. Okay? Any doubts here? Therefore, first we have to compare length of string 1 with the length of string 2. If length itself is not equal, we can display the message string not equal. Then suppose L1 equal to L2, if the length of string 1 equal to length of string 2, then we can proceed further. By the time compare individual characters, okay, if everything is fine, everything is equal, then display the appropriate message string equal, otherwise string not equal. Now here operation of loop equal label, therefore how loop equal works. Therefore if you execute loop equal, first thing is it is going to decrement CX by 1. The second step is if CX not equal 0 and 0 flag is set. If both are true, then only the control goes to the specified location label. Otherwise it is going to execute next immediate instruction, means it comes out of the loop. Therefore now just I'm going to give the demo for this. So this is the instruction. Sairam here, okay, let it be, I'm going to type Sriram, okay, now save this program, say go to this, okay, now compile this program, masm/zi, the name of the program is compare string byte, cmpsp, I give the instruction name, then no error, link/co, cmpsp compare string byte, okay fine, then cls, go to code view, cmpsp compare string byte. Now here this is the program we have. Now what I am going to do is, I want to display all the things. Now let it be question mark L1. Say I want to know the length of string 1, L1. That is, say what is the length of string 1? 6. In the same way, the length of string 2 is what? This also 6. Here the length, actually L1 contains, L1 gives the length of string 1 and L2 gives the length of string 2. Now we can find everything over here. Then finally, what we'll do is we have to display the message, appropriate message on the monitor. Therefore, actually code view is not required. Therefore, just I want to show the content of L1 and L2. This here both are 6, but length is equal, but actually strings are not equal because here Sai Ram is there, here Sri Ram is there. Therefore, I have to display string not equal. Therefore, quit from this. Now what we can do is, therefore, just give the name of the file, compare string byte, then enter. That is string not equal. String not equal because Sai Ram and here Sri Ram. Therefore, string not equal. So what we can do is, that is here make it Sai Ram. It's a case sensitive. That's both case must be same. Okay. Now here Sai Ram. Now Sai Ram. Here also Sai Ram. Here also Sai Ram. Save this file. Okay. Then go to this one. Now what happened? Compile once again. /getdie. Then what do you call cmp cmp sp compare string byte, then no error, link /0 cmp sp compare string byte, say no error. Actually here what happened, that is cmp sp, that is cmp sp compare string byte, say illegal compare, sorry, here the link /0 CMPSB semicolon. Okay, fine. Now what you have to do is, that is just can give the name of the program, compare string byte, that is string equal, because here Sai Ram string equal, string equal. Now what we can do is instead of compare string byte, I'm going to use prefix called repeat equal, REP, repeat equal, repeat equal. Then we can remove this instruction, that is this one. Now what happened? Now this is instruction, just with the help of single instruction, we can able to compare two string. But before executing this, we have to initialize everything. That is segment address of string 1 must be in ES, segment address of string 2 must be in ES, the offset address of string 1 must be in SI, the offset address of string 2 must be in DIS, the count must be in CX, okay. Count must be in CX because a repeat equal uses CX. The count must be in CX. Then first we are going to compare the length of string 1 with the length of string 2. The length itself is not equal, then we can display the message string not equal. But your strings are equal, then it comes here. Then if you go for this, it's keep on comparing each and everything. Okay. Now what is the meaning of repeat equal? Say it comes here. Then after comparing two characters from string 1 and string 2, the control comes over here, it decrements CX by 1. If CX is not equal to 0 and 0 flag is set, then come here. Means if both characters are equal, it's keep repeating. Repeat if equal. That is, keep executing compare string byte if both characters are equal. So it's keep on doing until CX equal to 0. Once CX becomes 0, it comes out. Then I'm checking the status of 0 flag. If 0 flag is reset, means if it is not equal somewhere, then string not equal display that message, otherwise display string equal. Okay, now what you can do is, you can save this program because I modified this particular code. Now just compile masm /getdie, then cmpsp, then no error, link /0 cmpsp compare string byte, say here no error. Then just what you have to do is, so just give the file name compare string byte, that is string equal, string equal, because here the what is the message, Sai Ram, here Sai Ram, so both are equal, so that's why we are getting this particular message, that is Sai Ram, that means a string equal. So what we can do is, you can change any other things, so definitely you will get the output. Any doubts here? Okay. Therefore, here we have two version. The one is compare string byte loop equal. So loop equal is a separate instruction. Loop equal is a separate instruction. We can replace loop equal by repeat equal. Repeat equal is a prefix. We have to use repeat equal for appropriate instruction. Therefore, with the help of single instruction, we can able to compare two string. I am going to use this instruction in the next lecture for palindrome. What is palindrome? Take one string, reverse a string, compare those two strings, then if string equal, we can say it's palindrome, otherwise it is not palindrome. Therefore, this instruction is very important. It's a prerequisite for the next program for palindrome. Therefore, it's very important. Therefore, with the help of single instruction, we can able to compare. We can able to compare what? Two string. Any doubts here? Any doubts? Okay. That is loop equal. Like that, we have a repeat equal compare string. But here, repeat equals after executing execution of this instruction comes here, decrement cx by 1. If cx not equal to 0 and 0 flag is set, when both conditions are true, then only it comes here. Then go back to this. Then once again do this job. When this condition as well this condition is true, then it keep doing this. What's the meaning of this? Repeat equal. If both characters are equal, then it's keep executing compare string byte. If any one condition is false, either this or this, if any one condition is false, it comes out of the loop. Okay, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. For more videos, visit my website.